taken by evil, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, that you spared us another week, Lord God, another day, Lord God. God, we appreciate you on today, Lord God. We thank you that you are our strength, Lord God, and you are our guidance, Lord Jesus. We appreciate you, Lord God. We look to you today, Lord God. No other help that we know of, Lord God. God, we love you today, Jesus. We thank you for sending your son, Jesus, to die on the cross for our sins. God, we appreciate you, Lord God. What great love you have for us, Lord God. And we appreciate you today, Lord Jesus. There is no failure in you, Lord God, and we look to you in all things, Lord God. God, how we meet you on today throughout the nation, our families, God, we need you, and we look to you, Lord God. You are our hope, you are our shield and our buckler, Lord God. You are our strong tower that we can find safety when we run to you, Lord God. God, I thank you, Lord God, because you just love us with an everlasting love. Your love never fails, and we appreciate you on today, Lord Jesus. God, I ask, Lord God, that you would begin the service, Lord God. By your Holy Spirit. Bless every song that will be sung and bless the preached word on today, Lord God. Use your ministry, Lord God, on today. And she may be bombs and food on today, Lord God, as she delivers the word, Lord God. And give us hearts to receive, ears to hear, and hearts to receive your word with gladness. God, we appreciate you and we love you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you is not enough, but thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Lord God. You're so merciful and so kind, Lord God. Now the service is in hand. Do what you want done and have what you want said. Have our way in Jesus' name. Amen. We'll have praise and worship. Following that, we'll have our bishop's corner, my sister April Turner. Then we'll have the bread of life by Mr. Lee Robin McCurry. And then we will be in the hands of our Mission Georgia.
city of Pottsville, Pennsylvania, the broken end of a high voltage wire was lying on the pavement. About that time, an engineer came walking by, unaware of the fact that he was about to step on it and be fried. A worker saw the dangerous situation and yelled to warn him, but his voice was drowned out by the loud noise around him. Picking up a stone, the worker threw it as hard as he could and hit the engineer in his chest. Reacting in anger, the engineer turned to confront his assailant, but just as he did, he saw the live wire that he was about to step on. Cheerfully, he thanked the worker for saving his life. The stone that hit his chest hurt, but the high voltage wire would have hurt much more or even killed him. It was a loving act of concern that motivated the worker to throw the stone at the engineer. Think about this story the next time the Lord brings trials into your life. We often get angry with God for throwing stones at us. These tribulations are never pleasurable and in most instances cause pain and suffering. But what we ought to do is to possess the same attitude as his engineer and be thankful. For your heavenly Father loves his children too much to let us be destroyed by going astray. Keep this message close to your heart. You'll live a better life. God bless.
Somebody didn't have an opportunity to come to the house of God today. There's a lot going on in this world, and I'm learning sometimes to thank God every minute, hour by hour, minute by minute. He is a good God all the time, and I don't have enough time. I'm on a time limit to talk about how good God is to me personally, and I know you all have your respective stories, but he is worthy of the praise on today. So I thank God for being here. I thank the bishop for allowing this opportunity. Amen. And no tag you're in. You're asking to prepare for today. Praise God. But it's an honor. And it's an honor to come before you. Shout out to those that are on social media. Thank you for tuning in. And please stay tuned. Praise God. We'll see what the Lord has. A little something, how God deals with me. Usually it's for me. Praise God. Definitely there's a lot that I can work on. We're all works in progress. But I just want to share, take a few moments and share what I believe the Lord has given to me, and perhaps some of you all can benefit from this word of today. And shout out to Bishop for his birthday. His birthday was on yesterday. I won't say his name, Jamie, but he's up there. He's up there. He's lived a long time. But he's been alive a long time. It's a blessing, amen. How many know that longevity of life, amen? The Lord promises that, amen, when you honor your parents and when you just love the Lord, you can expect at least 70, praise God. Hope for it, that's what the Lord says. So we thank God for Bishop, and we had a blessed time on yesterday. And just thank God for those of you that are out, amen, and those that are tuning in. Let's pray. Prayer is always in order. Let's pray that the Lord's will be done, Lord. We thank you again for this day. It's a day that you have made, and we are happy. We are exceedingly glad to be in the land of the living, and Lord, just allow me to be used of you, God. I don't want it to be Robinology, but I want it to be your word, Lord Jesus. And let me impart what thus saith the Lord in the few minutes that I have, and continue to bless those that are here with us, those that are tuning in social media, that they may receive what thus hath the Lord. And we ask all these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So, an area, again, I'm a work in progress, but the Lord has been dealing with me on is patience. Amen. Waiting on God. Elder Rochelle hit it on the nail last week when she talked about resting in God and just leaning on him. Even when things get tough or rough, it's important to rest in the Lord. It's not easy. I have not mastered it by any feet, but I'm learning. I'm going to learn today, as my stepdaughter always says to her baby girl. You're going to learn today. No, I'm going to learn today, amen. And hopefully, you all will glean something from this word. So the Lord took me to Psalm 40. It is one of my favorite psalms outside of Psalm 91. Psalm 40, and I'm going to read two versions. We can stand and read the King James Version. I have it here in my notes, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for your word. We'll read Psalm 40, 1 through 3. King James, we can read it In unison, praise God, I waited patiently for the Lord, and he inclined unto me and heard my cry. He brought me up also out of a horrible pit, out of the miry clay, and set my feet upon a rock and established my goings. He had put a new song in my mouth, even praise unto our God. Many shall see it and fear and trust in the Lord. Amen. You can take your seats at this time. I'm going to read the Message version of it. You don't have to stand again. Psalm 41:3, but the Message. I like the Message. I think Elder Mary and a few others have talked from the Message. It kind of puts it in maybe layman's terms, where if there's any doubt about you understanding what thus saith the Lord, go to the Message Bible. Amen. But I do like to start with the King James version. It says, I waited and waited and waited for God. At last he looked, and finally he listened. Let's just stop there. How many have waited and waited for anything, right? Waited and waited for money to come through, praise God, thank God for this. I've got a few people in the audience that have waited for somebody to come through for you, right? Maybe somebody that had promised you something, or they were going to do something on your behalf that benefited you, amen. Or you're waiting for a new opportunity, right? Or you're waiting, right? Waiting is part of life. It's definitely part of life as a Christian. But I like the Message in Psalm 41. It says, I waited and waited and waited for God. And we can wait for God on a number of things, right? It's not just, you know, the typical things, money. We all can use that, more of that. But it could be your health. It could be a situation, you know, with you physically. It could be a situation in relationships or marriage where you're waiting. You're waiting for God to do something on your behalf or for a change to occur. And then it says in Psalm 40, verse 2, he lifted me up out of the ditch. And we'll talk about the ditch of being in the pit. But that's, wow, okay, David, you're in a ditch, all right? He pulled him from the deep mud, right? So typically when you think of pits or ditches, they're kind of slimy or gritty. And I remember many years ago, there was a small child that got fallen into a ditch and got stuck. And it was very hard to get that child out, you know, even with, you know, all of the tools and everything that we have even today in this modern era, being stuck in a ditch or falling into a pit, that's not fun, right? That's not fun. We'll talk more about that. But it says, he stood me up on a solid rock to make sure I wouldn't slip. And that's the good news about our Lord and Savior. He can make sure that he can help us out of any situation, any ditch, any pit. And we'll talk about a little bit more of that in a few minutes. Verse 3 out of the Message Bible, Psalm 40, verse 3, it says, he taught me how to sing the latest God song. I like that. It's the latest God song. A praise song to our God. More and more people are seeing this. They enter the mystery, abandoning themselves to God. So as we're waiting, amen, it's teaching us patience. It's teaching us to lean on God. When we think about being in, again, a ditch or a pit, I'm going to be honest, it's not fun. It could be, you feel isolated. Some of the things that I have researched, what does it mean to be in a pit? You know, when we apply it to our everyday lives and challenges, it could be a number of life's trials. Again, it could be health, relationship issues, financial issues, just various struggles, right, that we all have. We all have them, amen. The Word of God says all have come short of the glory of God, so we can sit and look like we don't, but we do. I know I have a lot of things that I need the Lord to help me with. The pit is also a place where we feel as if there's no way out. So, and the enemy is very cunning and very tricky, and when you're stuck in a pit type of situation, and that's the analogy, right? I mean, maybe we're not in a pit physically, but we feel we're in a pit because of the situation, right? Whether it's a loss we've gone through or some sort of transition or some sort of situation that is making us feel stuck. How many have felt stuck? Maybe stuck in a job, stuck in a bad relationship, stuck with yourself, stuck with myself, amen. If I'm, you know, not doing as I should, amen, aligning with God's word, you know. It's not always that it's something else that's causing the problem. Sometimes we've caused the sin or the problems, and we're stuck. We're in a pit, as David says. We're in a ditch type of situation where we feel isolated, right? And then it can make you feel like you're the only one, even though we know we're not. Other people go through things, but when you're in it, when you're in that struggle, you can feel at times like, wow, I'm dealing with this, this, and this, and Lord, where are you, right? Lord, help. Lord, deliver me. The pit is often considered a low place when we think about being in a pit or a ditch, you know, in our life. It's a low point. It's not fun, right? It's not really like going to the amusement park, or oh, I'm going to see a fun sight, or doing something fun with friends or family, or going to the movies like we did yesterday. It's no, you feel low. You feel abandoned. You feel like you're all alone. But there's good news, amen. We know that in Christ Jesus, we are not just stuck, because God is above. How many of us above a circumstance? He's above. He's the God, I'll say it, of the pit. Amen. And I know this before, but it probably it's good to note it again, that oftentimes we're not always responsible for the pit situation. Even if it's a job loss, you could have been doing everything. I've been there. You can. And the company decides to move. They decide to send your job to India. That's neat, you know. And God bless those that need jobs, everybody across the world, but you can do your best, amen. And sometimes, you know, you're impacted, right? Or it could be just you. You cause the situation, you know. You overspent. You haven't made the best decisions. You are too happy about life and getting, you know. And no, we can all, you know, it's not always others, right? Sometimes it's us. It's me, it's me. As the song says, stand in the need of prayer. So, impacted areas, health, finances, a number of things, our emotions, right? Our peace. When you're in the pit, you're typically not at peace, right? You're scrambling. At least I know if I'm in an isolated situation, I'm wondering, Lord, where are you? And oftentimes, we will lean to our own understanding. Even those of us that are Christians, we know God has brought us through. He's done miracles. We heard last week, the elder talked about how he miraculously healed her son, and has done many things. We've all got our miracle testimonies or stories of what God has done, but when you're in it, amen, I'll just say, make it personal. When you're going through, or when I'm going through something, you can just feel like, Lord, all you know, what is breaking loose? And help, God, you know, and we can help to our own flesh, to our own carnal knowledge, right? A hustle here, a hustle there, in a good way, praise Jesus. But it's a hustle mentality, right? Because that's the world. We're in this world, right? So we will be subjected to those thoughts, right? Whether you hear something on TV and how to make a quick buck, or someone tells your friend, this is what you can do to get out of your situation. That's what's important, to seek God for wisdom and to pray about it, right? Because even though something is good, and I've been there, and you may feel like, oh, the Lord blessed, or the Lord added, it's not always what the Lord had designed. Maybe I didn't lean on him. I was leaning on my own knowledge. And it's pride. I'm just tap dancing around it, but I know for me it's pride. You know, I'm thinking I need to fix this mess that I'm in, and really it's God. It's godly wisdom and God that will help me. The only one that can truly help me out of any mess. I know for me that's when God does it, he does it right. He doesn't half do it. He doesn't, you know, just go through the motions with it. When he delivers and when he provides a solution, it's perfect. Amen. So what happens, you know, while in the pit? Again, even the best of us, you know, we don't put our trust in the Lord, like Psalm 41 and 4 says, or Psalms 40 and 4. You know, we're leaning to our own understanding, which is not good. And when we're in the pit, it's easy. It's just easy to grab to, you know, what will help us get out of the situation quickly? I don't know about y'all, but when you're in a pit or in a distressful situation, you want to know, what can I do to make a quick move? You know, you want it to be gone. No one wants to be in pain or distress. That's the human nature, right? Our human frailty. We don't want to be in the struggle for any length of time, right? I know that at least I'll speak for myself. Lord, I need you to help and help today. Help now. Yes. Amen. So some strategies. Like David, it's something simple that the Lord reminded me. You just need to cry out to me and say, help, Lord. Sometimes it's as simple as that. Help, Lord. Help me immediately in this situation. Now, you all may think it's interesting. You know, I don't know if you've ever been there, but I have seen God move instantaneously. I have cried out to him, as David did, and he heard my plea in that situation. He gave me wisdom, or he turned the situation around just like that. Somebody came through to say a positive word to combat a negative, you know, atmosphere in a meeting or in a situation. I've seen God do it instantaneously when I have chosen to lean on him. Amen. And part of this waiting patiently, going back to Psalm 41, it's not easy, but as you're waiting, the Lord was reminding me, and as I was studying, it's not like you're twiddling your thumbs, you're just, oh, I'm just waiting for the Lord. You know, it's you're acting, you know, you're recalling the testimonies, what God has done for you previously, and how He's the same God. He's the God of the circumstances. He's the God above the circumstances. His ways aren't Robin's ways. They're God's ways, right? And nobody can match Him. Nobody can beat Him. He is a guarantee. You know, whenever He does something, it is for sure, and it's all for our good. Amen. And so while you wait for the Lord to, you know, to guide you or to change a situation or to give revelation, it's important to recall the testimony and to thank God and to start praising Him. We've got some wonderful praisers in here, and sometimes I just start praising Him. I'm out walking, Lord, I'm just giving You the glory. I'm just listening to my favorite gospel song. I'm sending up Judah, that summoning the angels, that's letting God know, I'm leaning on You. I need You to handle this battle or this situation or this pit experience. And, you know, your spirit can become lifted in that praise. It takes the focus off of the problem or the situation, amen, or the struggle. And then you're like, I'm feeling good, Lord. I'm giving You the glory. And maybe You don't have the full answer, but it puts you in a better state of mind, a better frame, a better point of reference, amen. And now God tells me, now you're leaning on Me. Now you're learning to trust in Me. He's got all the answers. And I think Elder had said last week, Elder Rochelle did, you've got to realize, and I heard TJ say this too early this week, they were saying the same thing basically. Everything that you do, you really have to lean on God. Now, we're not robots, amen. We have free moral will. We have the opportunity to think, to do. God, we're not puppets, right? But it's important as Christians, we have to rely on Him. He will lead and guide us into all truth, because if we don't, then there's frustration and there's confusion. Then you may go a different way. God can still work it out for your good when you come back to Him. But I'm learning, as I'm going to learn today, to lean to Him for everything. When I mean everything, everything. Your mate, your decision making on what career path you're going to take, whether you stay here in Arizona, whether you go, whether you want to pursue this endeavor or that endeavor, it's important to lean on Him. And when you do that, you're stripping away your pride. I'm saying, Lord, forget my limited intellect or what I think I know. God, You know everything. He knows the end from the beginning. He knows if there's going to be a car accident around the corner. He knows who's going to be for you or not for you on the job. So when you can just take the moment and say, Lord, we're human. We're going to be succumb to this world, and we're going to think about things ourselves, right, and what we can do. But if you can ask the Lord to help you, Lord, help me to rely on You for everything. He will take care of all of your needs. Everything. Income, job, whatever. I've spoken it into the app. Lord, I need this, this, and I need to be able to work from home, and I need this, and He's done it. He's a faithful God. I'm not perfect. He is. And He's faithful. And He does honor, you know, He does honor you, and He will hear your plea when you cry out. And again, just like David, you just said, help, Lord. So while we're waiting on the Lord, and I'm wrapping this up, this is just pretty simple things. Most of you already know to do this, but this was a reminder for me. Like David, he was waiting patiently, and the Lord did finally hear his plea. Psalm 37:7 is another scripture to rest. We heard that on last week from Elder Rochelle, to learn to rest in the Lord. It says, rest in the Lord and wait patiently for Him. Do not fret because of him who prospers in this way, because of the man who carries out wicked schemes. So we can't always look to the world and compare. The world is the world. The Bible says God reigns on the just and the unjust. Some people can be blessed in the world, some people not. But as Christians, we know if we put our confidence in God, He will see us through, and it'll be the right way. And it'll be a sustainable blessing. It won't be a popcorn type of blessing, or it's here today and then it's gone tomorrow. Amen. Like sometimes the blessings are, they're not, you know, of the Lord. Psalm 37 and 9 says, for evildoers will be cut off, but those who wait, amen, wait on the Lord, they will inherit the land. And so what that means to me in these days and times is we can inherit blessings this side of heaven, what God has for us. Houses, whatever it is, it could be cars, it could be, it doesn't always have to be material things, it could be, you know, peace of mind, but you can inherit the blessings of God. You have to put your trust in Him and wait. And in Psalm 37 and 34, wait for the Lord and keep His way, and He will exalt you to inherit the land. When the wicked are cut off, you will see it. But what does it mean to wait on the Lord? All through the Psalms, it gives you 7 clues, maybe even more I wrote down. But certainly it's putting your trust in God. It's not leaning to your own man-made or woman-made devices, your own life. God's ways are not our ways. Many of you have told me your testimonies. From Chicago to Arizona, not really knowing hardly anyone, but he said, go. He's done that for Elder Michelle and for others, where God has said, make a move, go to Arizona, without many resources, without any friends, without a church home, but God has led and provided. And so it's important to know he's got the knowledge. The Lord Jesus has everything that we are in need of. There is no failure in him. And when we can put our trust, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter if your spouse doesn't trust you, if your sister doesn't believe in it. When you put your trust in God, he is a for sure thing. He is a guarantee. And when you learn to wait on him, he can teach you patience, like I needed this morning with little Ziza. I needed patience. She didn't know this was the message, but it was for me. Praise God, amen, because when you're dealing with youngsters, they're young, and then they're very rambunctious, and you just have to watch them. But in that, it's a blessing to have her, and to see her thrive and grow, and it's teaching me patience, Robin. Just like I want God to have patience with me, I need to sow seeds of patience. And I want to encourage you all today. It's not easy. Again, I've not mastered it. I'm tested I'm tested on this, but I'm learning to put my confidence in God, because he is all-knowing, and he is the great provider, and he can do anything but fail. And I just hope you all have been at least blessed somewhat from this. Keep your trust in the Lord, and thank you, Bishop, for this opportunity. I'll turn that over to you.
Get off at Gilbert and take the tool to all the way around. By that time, you could have been home. But it's something about movement, isn't it? When you have to be still as well. You'd rather go all the way and take more time, more gas, put more miles on the car, just so you have a mindset. And so a lot of us are going round and round instead of waiting on the Lord. What a message. We must have patience. We must learn how to wait on the Lord. Waiting on the Lord may mean that you don't involve yourself in a car accident. Waiting on the Lord may mean that your life is spared. We've heard several testimonies. One of Sister Janae's husband, that when they had in 1989, when they had that great earthquake in California, how he was going his regular way home. But then something paused. He ended up going another direction. And when he did that, he missed, I think it was, what is the 880 exchange? The 880 exchange that fell and killed all those people. But because the Lord took him another way, his life was spared. Sister Veronica Easter's daughter, on 9/11, worked for the Pentagon, was on her way to work, and just bought a new Cadillac Escalade. And something was sounding wrong. So instead of going to work, she took it to the shop. And in so doing, where the plane would have hit her, she was in another place. I'm learning, again, I'm saying I'm learning that when I've done all I know how to do and something happens, to just chill. Take a chill pill. Amen. Because God may be saving your life. Come on, let's give the Lord an offering of praise. If you're watching us and you are at home and you don't know the Lord Jesus and the pardon of your sins, right where you are has now become an altar. If you accept the Lord Jesus Christ as your personal Savior and ask Him to come into your heart, you can be saved. So if you want to pray that prayer today, Lord, forgive me of my sins. I acknowledge I am a sinner. Lord, I can do nothing of myself. Lord, I need you. Right where you are, you don't have to wait another second. God can save you right where you are. So pray that prayer, amen. But God has more for you. He wants to infill you with His Spirit. He wants, amen, to secure your eternity with Him in heaven. If you've done that today, we want you to let us know that you've accepted God into your life. If you need prayer today, there's something that is happening in your life, know that God is here for you, and God will heal you. Over the building today, won't you pray with me? Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day. Lord, this is the day that you've made, and we choose to rejoice and be glad in it. We choose to wait on you, Lord, patiently, for you have inclined your ear unto us. Father, we pray for those who have said they want to be saved, have opened their heart to you, Lord. Now, fill them with your Spirit, Lord. Help them, Lord, that they will learn more of you. For those that are sick and afflicted, that are under the sound of our voice, we pray for their healing today. We pray for deliverance for those who are bound by disease, bound by alcoholism, bound by drug addiction. Those that are bound by racism and hatred, we rebuke that enemy right now in the name of Jesus. We cast every care upon you today, Lord, knowing you care for us, and we will praise you for it. And all the glory and honor belongs to you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Give the Lord an offering of praise. If you have an offering today, if you have not already done so by Cash App or by PayPal, amen, this is your opportunity to give to the kingdom of the Lord. We're grateful this is Passion Week, amen, that began, amen, with Palm Sunday. Amen, we're looking forward to next Sunday being Resurrection Sunday. We're looking for God to do great things. Amen. We're looking for God to resurrect some things in your life. Amen. This is springtime, a time of bringing in the new. So we're looking for God to do great things for us, not only in New Vision Christian Fellowship, but right where you are. So we are grateful for all that God has done for you and for what he's going to do. And we will give him praise and honor today. Amen. We thank God for you today. And before we close today, we want to thank you, those of you who were so gracious enough to send out birthday wishes to us. Those of you who put a little something in the cards and in the Cash App, we are grateful for you today. We're also grateful for our family, those who I was able to live vicariously through on yesterday. My daughter Chantel, and Elder Rochelle Starks, and Sister Jasmine Starks, and Ebony Starks, and Edward Starks, they did something, amen, that I personally would not do. They jumped out of a perfectly good airplane on yesterday at 10,000 feet and went skydiving, amen. And thank God they did it, amen. And so I'm able, amen, to live vicariously through them. Amen. And today, amen, we also want to give a congratulations out to Sister Kimberly Welch, amen, who graduated from South Mountain Community College, amen, with her associate's degree. Those of you at home, everybody, let's give it up for Sister Kimberly. God bless you. God bless you. Amen. A faithful worker. Amen. What I can say about the Welch family, they are all faithful workers. And we are so appreciative of those things that they do for not only vision, but for me. Amen. We're grateful for that. Man, on Tuesday is our Bible study from 7 to 8. And Wednesday is our day of fasting for our assembly from morning to your evening meal. Again, next Sunday is Easter or Resurrection Sunday. Amen. We're looking for a high time of the Lord, and we are trusting to have on next week a Easter egg hunt. Yes, brothers and sisters, we know that rabbits don't bring forth eggs. We know all that stuff, but amen, it's a time of fellowship. So let us fellowship without, amen, those being judgmental. Amen. We're just going to let the young people or the children enjoy themselves on next Sunday. And also next Sunday, we're going to have communion. So those who are watching and will not be able to be with us, please prepare your elements on next Sunday. Amen. So that we can not only think of what Christ did for us, amen, through Passion Week, but the fact that he gave his life up for you and for me. And on Thursday morning, he got up with all power in his hand. And because he got up, I can get up. Hallelujah. Why would you just take a minute? Because he got up, you can get up. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank God for that. And on the 6th of April, amen, will be our next Ask Bishop George, amen, Zoom call, the question and answer. So please, those who have questions, please let us know what those are. You can do so by texting it to our church number at 480-704-4830. That's 480-704-4830. Or you can email it to my address at newvpastorg@yahoo.com. Man, we want to continue to pray for Mother Tucker, Deacon Thomas, Deaconess Jessie Alexis, Elder Michelle Wilson, Sister Tanya Stewart, and let me add Elder Rochelle Starks. Amen. She had a beautiful flight, but the landing was not the best. Praise the Lord. So we will continue to pray for you, Sister Stark. I thank you. She said she'd still do it in a heartbeat. Amen. God bless you. Amen. Let's keep in our prayers. All of those that are affected by COVID-19. Amen. And those that are waiting patiently for your stimulus. Amen. Keep waiting. Amen. Keep on waiting. Keep trusting the Lord. Amen. Thank you. Yeah, it's on the way. It's on the way. Amen. And let us pray for peace in Jerusalem. President Biden, our national, state, and local authorities, and let us keep in our daily prayers all the families of and our first responders, healthcare workers, law enforcement officers, military forces around the world as they defend liberty for all Americans and world citizens alike. And as we close today, if you do not have a church home, New Vision Christian Fellowship is good ground. If you so desire, you can go on our website and you can put in your information to become a member of our church. God bless you. In Jesus' name, we will stand and be dismissed. Father, we thank you for your word today. We thank you for the messenger. We appreciate the things that you have done for us and for the things that you're going to do for us. Father, as we look to this week, as we think about Passion Week and the things that took place this week many years ago, over 2,000 years, the things that you endured, not for you, but for us. We are grateful for it, Lord. We are thankful for the things that you have done. Now, Lord, we ask that you would bless us as we leave this place. Keep us from hurt, harm, or danger. Then bring us back at that point in time. This we pray in Jesus' name. And everyone said amen. God bless you in Jesus' name.